Hey guys, what is going on? It is Chris here with another video. I finally finished my Scar-17. Making this video has been taking me a while, so I'm just gonna get right into it so I don't have to use another take. But, so I'm just gonna field strip the weapon. First, take off this pin. Wow, in that time. Okay, comes out. There we go. Came out. Now, peel the back off. This is the lower receiver. Alright. So the magazine, I took the magazine out. This is the magazine. Has that spring on the top, that angled piece, so that the magazine lock goes in place. Mag release can open up. Anyway, so you have your, it's on safety right now, actually. So this is the full trigger. It goes all the way back to the gray piece. This is safety. It only goes back, like, pretty much the entire way, except to touch it. So how that works is in here, this piece folds over that white piece and kind of blocks it, and then when it's on fire, the full thing goes. Alright. This is the bolt lock right here. When you put the magazine in, that spring piece pushes up on it, but it's able to move up and down. So when the bolt is over, it's in the down position, but when it gets, the bolt goes back, then it locks up in front of the bolt, and then when you push on the bolt lock, then it releases the bolt and it goes forward. But that only happens when the magazine is in. Simulates an empty magazine. The magazine release is ambidextrous. That means it's on both sides. So there's the button on this side, and then there's the thing on this side. The button on the other side. Okay. Works. It's pretty cool. I enjoyed doing that. It was a fun little thing that I would like to put in. So the next part is stock. The stock just slides out the bottom. It doesn't just slide out the bottom, it clicks into the top, and it is kind of scary to take out sometimes. Anyways, this is the stock. It is adjustable, so you press this. This is 6. Oh shoot. This is 5. This is 4. 3. 2. And 1. And they all lock in place. It doesn't go in, so like it's not gonna go in, but it will come out without pushing the button, so that's something. This would usually be the button, this red piece right here, but it didn't work out the way I wanted to. The way I did this within a 3 wide space was a little challenging. I don't know if I want to show you guys. I kind of want to keep my secret. I will say that I somewhat used Island's custom Lego mechanism. He inspired. He was. I based mine off of his, but I've changed a lot of things considering I could only use 3 wide space. Alright, so with the stock, like I said, it folds over. So you press this red button right here. Folds over all the way to the side. It doesn't lock into the side of the gun, even when it's on, but it does completely stay to the side and folds back over. You press the button, it locks in place. Can hold its own weight. There. The cheek rest is adjustable, so you press in on this gray piece. Goes up 3 positions, so there's second position and third position. So at the top, it's sturdy enough for you to rest your head on or your cheek on. And I usually either have it in the first position or the second position, so right here. And when you have the stock in, it still is able to adjust all the way through. In the back, see right there. The back of the gun is 4 studs. The buttstock is 4 studs wide. The top and everything like that. That was on purpose. It's the bottom, and that's a little sling mount right there. I'm gonna set that aside. Alright, now onto the upper receiver. So first off, I'm gonna take off the iron sights and the gas piston, because these are just gonna break off eventually. Alright, so next part, I'm going to take out the charging handle, the bolt, and the spring. So split the back open a little bit, pull back on the charging handle to get this out. Don't want to pull, there we go. just comes right out. Take the charging handle out, set that aside, and then push it out the rest of the way. I wish I could make it easy. There we go. Alright, just comes out right the back. Just comes right out the back. Alright. So here you have the bolt. This is what the actual bolt looks like, except there'd be I don't know what there is, but there's like this little tube piece that comes in right there. I don't have that because I didn't have enough room for that. But anyways, this is what that looks like, and that's where the charging handle goes in right there. The charging handle can be switched from left to right depending on what your preference is. And this is the guiding rod, this is the spring and everything like that. This piece right here with the yellow rubber band simulates the spring, but it retracts and it goes inside of this slot right there. And you can see on the side it has the divots, and that's further so that there's room for the rubber bands. So that works very well. Surprisingly, it has a lot of force behind it. Alright. So next up, we're going to take out the barrel. I'm going to put the gas piston back on. Alright, so take the rails and the rear thing, the pad thing off. It's off. Then we're going to take the charging handle piece. I'm gonna take this piece, push it through, and then push it the other pin through as well. There we go. Alright, now set this down, and then take that pin out, and then the barrel comes out and separates from the upper receiver. Now this is a complete standalone piece for the upper receiver. Alright, there's not much to do with this. There's just the tactile rail on top, and that actually, the iron sight took off part of the tactile rail. So that's wonderful. Here you have the front and the little opening in the front. And in the front you have a sling, two sling mounts. Alright, so this is the barrel and gas piston. Here you have your flash hider, and you have the thread for mounting a suppressor or something, or attaching a suppressor. And here you have that little wraparound piece for the gas piston, and you have the bottom tactical rail and your barrel, and everything like that. And this part right here is where this is the part that attaches to the lower receiver. Alright, so. This is the last thing I'm going to show. This is the iron sight, and that's the piece that it took with it on accident. That's not supposed to do that. This is the iron sight. Flips down, flips up, and I could use a 1x1 right there with the hole in the middle, but I wanted to use this because I thought it looked better, kind of. If you, I'm going to be showing side by sides at the end of what this looked like, sort of. And these grooves are there for adjusting. It's to give so you can have better grip on the to spin this to adjust it. But yeah, that's what it looks like. You can move on the top. This piece is there's a cross. It goes when the piece that goes across is a lightsaber. That's what goes. That's what's connecting it, and it works to spin. Alright, so now I'm going to put it back together. Putting it back together is just the reverse of taking it apart. It's actually, I think it's easier to put it together than take it apart. So put the barrel in first. Get the pins to secure the barrel in. Alright. Now let's take the rails. Put these blue things back on. Alright. Okay. So that piece just came out. And that piece came out too. Alright. Anyways. So. Now, take the bolt and everything. Make sure that these rubber bands right here are not off to the side. or else they'll catch on the side of the weapon. So we're gonna stretch them out and push them on the towards the inside. And we take this, directly in the back. Alright, so, now, we'll take the stock, and put it, slide it into the back. Alright. Slide in. There we go. Oh, I forgot to put the charging handle in. There we go. Now take the low receiver, slide it into the slot that's in the back. Okay, I'm gonna just pause. Alright, so I got it in. Show me your soul. I gotta know. Best in. Beautiful inside. Where's the bullet? Where's that piece? Come take the wheel and drive. Let's put that in. Put it aside. There we go. Magazine in. Oh, everything is working fine. Trigger's working, yeah.